Dale Carnegie, the legendary author of How to Win Friends and Influence People, is perhaps the most well-known personal development author of all time. And his legacy continues to influence generations of people through his organization, Dale Carnegie Training. Their flagship training course, taken by tens of thousands of people worldwide, including U.S. presidents, Fortune 500 CEOs, and countless successful entrepreneurs, is the Dale Carnegie Public Speaking Course. Now, for the first time, this classic training course, normally costing thousands of dollars and delivered over several days or weeks, is available in this new learning system you are now listening to. Dale Carnegie Training continues their long-standing partnership with Nightingale Conant, having produced three bestsellers together, including the Dale Carnegie Leadership Mastery Course, the 5 Essential People Skills, and How to Make Yourself Unforgettable now brings you Stand and Deliver, the most complete self-study training course on public speaking and communication strategies ever developed. You'll first learn the basics and move quickly into actually delivering talks. You will be on your feet and presenting like a professional in no time at all. You'll create talks that have impact and persuade your audience using both basic and sophisticated techniques that you'll learn in this time-tested and practical program. You'll learn how to research and understand your audience, how to hone in on their specific interests and desires, how to easily organize your speech or presentation, knowing what to include, and maybe even more importantly, what not to include, how to hold an audience's attention, whether it's an audience of 20 or 1,000, for 5 minutes or 45 minutes, how to speak with confidence and clarity, using your voice like an instrument. You'll also learn how to use visual aids to perfect your timing, how to handle question and answer sessions with grace and power, and so much more. In Stand and Deliver, you'll be given all the tools you need to become an outstanding public speaker in the shortest possible time. You'll discover the real keys, not just for entertaining your listeners, but for informing them, persuading them, and inspiring them to action based on your message. And perhaps most importantly, Stand and Deliver will show you how to take the fear out of public speaking once and for all. Right now, you may see public speaking as a danger to be avoided or a challenge to be overcome. But make no mistake, when you reach the end of this program, you'll know that speaking in public is an opportunity to be fully and joyfully embraced every time you're asked. You'll now look forward to speaking whenever the occasion arises, and your ability to express yourself sincerely and forcefully will be a major asset in your career. Nothing builds confidence and charisma like the power to speak well in public, and this is simply the best course ever created for giving you that power. And now, the Nightingale Conant Corporation and Dale Carnegie Training are very pleased to bring you Stand and Deliver.
Welcome to Stand and Deliver, the most complete, powerful, and practical audio program ever created on the art and science of public speaking. Today, the Dale Carnegie Organization is the world's leading resource for public speaking mastery, and this has been true for almost a century. Just as certainly, the Nightingale Conant Corporation is the world leader in audio learning technology. Now, Dale Carnegie and Nightingale Conant are proud to bring you this definitive program on speaking in public. So, whether you're just starting out or if you already have extensive experience with oral presentations, Stand and Deliver will take you to the next level of mastery. So, let's get started. Literally, since the dawn of civilization, the ability to speak well in front of others has been an ongoing human challenge. This was especially true for the classical civilizations of Greece and Rome. But public speaking ability was also highly esteemed in biblical times and by Native American tribes and by the cultures of India and China. Fascinating as it might be, however, our purpose here is not a history lesson. So right at the outset, we're going to introduce 3 key tools for creating a high-impact presentation. These are timeless principles upon which all great speakers have relied, though each has done so in his or her own way. by blending your unique identity with the universal principles we're about to discuss, you can transform yourself into an effective public speaker almost instantly. So please listen closely. What you're about to learn will have a dramatic effect not only on how you communicate to others, but on how you see yourself as well. The fact is, human beings are talking beings. We start talking when we wake up in the morning and we keep at it until we go to sleep, and some people don't even stop then. But in order to be an effective presenter, you need to understand the major difference between ordinary talking and speaking in public. You need to master certain key skills that create the illusion that your presentation is as personal as a one-on-one conversation. But that illusion is only possible when you've professionalized yourself as a speaker. David Letterman has the ability to speak with virtually anybody while 10 million viewers are looking in. Yet he's able to make this seem as casual as a break at the office water cooler. Now, you may not think of David Letterman as a great public speaker, but he draws on the same principles that virtually every accomplished speaker has used since ancient times. What are these principles? The first one is actually quite obvious, and maybe that's why so many speakers seem to forget it. It can be stated in a single, very short sentence. Know what you're talking about. Learn the material so well that you own it. Don't just have some expertise in your topic, master it. Be able to fill every second of your presentation with solid content. Once you're able to do that, 90% of your work will be done before you even get up in front of the audience. To make this point, Dale Carnegie liked to invoke the example of Luther Burbank, a great scientist by any measure and probably the greatest botanist of all time. Burbank once said, "I have often produced a million plants in order to find one or two really good ones, and then I destroyed all the inferior specimens." A presentation ought to be prepared in that same lavish and discriminating spirit. Assemble 100 thoughts and discard 90, or even 99. Collect more material, more information than there is any possibility of employing. Gather it for the additional confidence it will give you, and for the sureness of touch. Gather it for the effect it will have on your mind and heart and whole manner of speaking. This is a basic factor in preparation, yet speakers constantly ignore it. Mr. Carnegie actually believed that speakers should know 40 times more about their topic than they share in a presentation. When speakers, especially inexperienced speakers, begin to prepare a talk, their biggest fear is not having enough to say to fill the allotted time. Most people worry that they'll run out of material in the middle of their talk, but they respond to this fear in a misguided way. They puff their presentation. They wind up trying to cram the story of their lives into their 15 minutes at the podium. The presentation gets bigger, but instead of really growing, it just swells. This is an especially dangerous pitfall for new speakers, since it's usually an unconscious process. The principle of knowing what you're talking about doesn't mean you have to say it all. You say just enough to fill your time effectively. You leave your audience wanting more. And if you've truly mastered your subject, they'll know that there is more. You'll project knowledge to them that's above and beyond your actual spoken words. To reach this level of mastery, you should begin preparing 10 days to 2 weeks before the event. Start your preparation by sitting down with a pencil and paper for 20 minutes, no less and no more, and writing at least 50 questions about your topic. 50 is the minimum, but you should definitely try for as many as possible. Write your questions as quickly as you can. Don't give them a lot of thought at this point. That's why the 20-minute time limit is important. This stage of preparation is a sprint, not a leisurely stroll through your mental library. During the first 20-minute session, what you're really doing is creating an outline for your talk, and I want to stress the importance of putting this in the form of questions. Research shows that this is much more stimulating to the brain than a conventional outline, and since you're not supplying answers at this point, it can also be done much faster. The answers will come later in other sessions leading up to your talk. Let me repeat, your first session should be limited to 20 minutes, and it should be done the old-fashioned way with an actual pencil and paper. Now in your second session, you'll start supplying answers to your questions and providing evidence for your ideas. This is when the computer becomes an essential tool. Begin by creating a document file of your questions. There should be at least 50, and quickly writing an answer for each one based on your own knowledge. Write this just as you would say it if you were sitting in Starbucks with a good friend. Unlike your first session, you don't have to limit yourself to 20 minutes, but don't feel as if you have to answer all of your questions either. Just keep at it until you feel your energy start to fade. And resist the temptation to use the internet to gather information. That will come later. Right now, your job is to access everything you know about your topic, which is probably a lot more than you think you know. It may take you several sessions to answer all the questions you wrote down, but that's no problem as long as you begin at least 10 days in advance. Just make sure that you complete your answers with 3 or 4 days left before the date of your talk. In those final sessions, you can surf the internet for facts and figures to enhance what you've already written. And remember this, you don't have to report everything there is to know about your topic. Ideally, you have total mastery of your subject, but that's for your benefit as much as for the audience. Mastery allows you to feel completely confident in your role as an authority. It's not something you have to demonstrate in the actual words that come out of your mouth. So pick and choose the really pertinent and hard-hitting information that you want to include. Think of your talk as a special meal you're preparing in your home for some honored guests. Don't think of it as a full-service restaurant. Sometimes there will be presentations for which you have little or no prior information. Other times the opposite will be true. For example, if you're talking about your own life or career, you'll already have a wealth of material on the subject. Your problem then is to select and arrange the information. Don't try to tell your audience everything, because it can't be done. Your talk will come off as sketchy and fragmented. On the other hand, if you're talking about something that's less familiar to you, avoid trying to cover this up with excessive research. Just be frank with yourself and your audience about your relationship to the topic. You don't have to say you feel inadequate about it, but you don't have to pretend you're a total expert either. You might want to take only one phase of your topic and enlarge upon it. Don't make your talk an abstraction.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.